Welcome students, this video is continuing in the previous video, that is physical device of physical design of IoT. Now in this we are just studying the model. So first model we have completed, and this is the second model, that is the publish subscribe model. So publish subscribe model is a communication model that involve the publishers, brokers and consumers. So publishers are the source of data, and publishers send the data to the topic which are managed by the brokers, and publishers are not aware of the consumers. So consumers subscribe to the topic which are managed by the broker. So when the broker receives the data for a topic from a publisher, it sends the data to all the subscribed consumer. Now the next is push pull model. Now in this model, push pull model, that is also a communication model in which the data producers push the data to queues, and the consumer pulls the data from the queues. So producers do not need to be aware of the consumers, and queues helps in decoupling the messaging between the producer and consumers. So queues also act as a buffer which helps in situation when there is a mismatch between the rate at which the producer push the data and the rate at which the consumer pulls the data. Now the next one is exclusive pair model. Now this exclusive pair model is a bi-directional full duplex communication model, and thus uses a persistent connection between the client and server. So connection is set up, it's remain upon until the client sends the request to close the connection, because it is a full duplex bi-directional communication model. So client and servers can send the message to each other after connection setup. So exclusive pair is stateful communication model, and server is aware of all the open connections. So this is the exclusive pair model. Now the IoT third part of this is IoT communication APIs. Generally we use two APIs for the IoT communication, and these two IoT communication APIs are REST based communication APIs, and another is WebSocket based communication APIs. REST based communication APIs represent the state transfer. Representational state transfer, that is REST, is a set of architectural principle by which we can design the web services, the web API that focus on systems resources and how resources states are addressed and transferred. So REST API that follow the request response communication model, and the REST architectural constraint apply to the component, connector and data elements. So within a distributed hypermedia system, the REST architectural constraints are client server, stateless and cacheable. Layered system, uniform inter and code on demand. So we have seen in very brief these things. Now client server, the principle behind the client server constraint is the separation of concern. For example, client should not be concerned with the storage of data without the concern which is concern of the server. Similarly, the server should not be concerned about the user interface which is concern of the client. So separation follows the client and servers to be independently developed and updated. Stateless, each request from client to server must obtain all the information necessary to understand the request and cannot take advantage of any storage context of the server. So thus session state is kept entirely on the client. Another is cacheable. So cache constraints require that the data within the response to a request be implicitly or explicitly labeled as cashable or non-cashable. If the response is cashable, then client cash is given the right to reuse the response data for later and equivalent request. So caching can partially or completely eliminate some instructions and improve efficiency and scalability. Layer system constraints. This constraints the behavior of components, such as each component cannot see beyond the immediate layer with which they are interacting. For example, client cannot tell whether it is connected directly to the end server or to an intermediary along the way. So system scalability can be improved by allowing intermediaries to respond to request instead of the end server without the client having to do anything different. Another is uniform interface. Uniform interface is another constraint that requires that the method of communication between client and server must be uniform. So resources are identified in the request and are themselves is separate from the representation of the resource data returned to the client. So when a client hold a representation of resources, it has all the information required to update or delete the resources. So we provide the client has required permission. So each message include enough information to describe how to process the message. And the another one is code on demand. This is the last one. So server can provide the executable code on a script for client to execute in their constraint. This constraint is only one that is optional. So a RESTful web service is a web API that implement using HTTP and REST principle. So REST is the most popular IoT communication APIs. Now another is WebSocket API, WebSocket based communication API. So WebSocket APIs allow the bi-directional full duplex communication between the client and server. So WebSocket API follows the exclusive pair communication model, unlike the request response model such as in REST. So the WebSocket API allows the full duplex communication and do not require new connection to be set up for each message to be sent. So WebSocket communication begins with a connection setup request sent by the client to the server. So the request that called the WebSocket handshake is sent over HTTP and server interpret it is an upgrade request. So it is if the server support the WebSocket protocol, the server respond to the WebSocket handshake response, and after the connection setup, client and server can send the data message to each other in full duplex mode. So WebSocket API reduce the network traffic and latency as there is no overhead for the connection setup and terminate the request for each message. So WebSocket suitable for IoT application and that have low latency and high throughput requirements. So the WebSocket most suitable for IoT communication APIs for IoT system. So this is all about this IoT communication APIs. Thank you to all of you.